Well, hey everybody, we're going to go ahead and get started. I am muting you all, but if you have a question about something, please pipe up, say something, because I say weird stuff all the time. And somebody else might also think it's weird. I have a block today. You are probably going to need to have a block at some point. If you don't have a block, you're like, I don't know what the heck I do with that. Make sure that it's just like, you can use a pillow or have something about that size around. Like I've used a beer growler for kind of having something to make your arm longer, a stack of books, something. You will need that and or a pillow at some point. I like to sit down on a little cushion because it helps to open the hips. Kind of creates a little bit more ease. Please come to a seat that is comfortable on your body and then stop worrying about whether or not it looks anything like what I'm doing with my body. Comfortable seat is just where we're trying to start off. I have a little gathering later today where getting some of my loved ones together. We call it family dinner. And my one friend is like super excited about this, and she's been like talking about this gathering that we're having to like everybody that we have run into this week, and it's been really hard because she's talking about it to people like as if she's kind of sort of inviting them, but she's not inviting them. And like she tried to invite some guy that I had like just met yesterday. I'm like, don't do that. Like, you have to worry about the words that you say to people and the way that you say them. Like, we're starting to like have this like exclusionary, like she's talking about this thing that we're going to, and she's like, well, but you're not going. I'm like, well, that's just rude as heck. Like, why are we discussing things in this way? And we've been getting into this conversation lately about how like the words that we say to people matter. And not everybody's gonna receive information the same way. I was talking about the first Yoga Sutra last week about how the practice of yoga begins now. And the second Yoga Sutra, it says that yoga is the ceasing of the stirring of the mind. And the idea behind this second sutra is that if those words resonate and make sense to you, then you achieve that, like, ceasing the stirrings of the mind, the practice of yoga comes to its fullness, and then you don't need the other like couple hundred sutras that explain more about how to do this. So if certain words make sense and resonate in a moment, then you're good. But if it doesn't, we need more. Like, you know, say like, okay, I'm having this gathering of friends, blah, 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 blah. We're getting there. Or saying like, I would really like to get together with you at a different time. Or like, we're keeping this intimate because like the COVID and stuff like that. But having to like insert more of an explanation into things sometimes. And like, we consider the physical practice with the body. Like, I have a lot of cues and words that I'll bring out, and things that have resonated to me or resonated to other folks that I've worked with, and like sometimes it doesn't work for everybody. So then we can start to come at that with more of an inquisitive place, like, I don't really get what you mean by that, or why don't we also look at it this other way or consider this other perspective with it. I've been very conscious of the way in which the way that we communicate with others and the way that we communicate with ourselves really matters. Like what I said at the beginning when you were coming into a seat, I want you to get comfortable. I want you to be in a place where your body's not resisting spending some time here and just kind of getting into like the concepts and intentions and then the breath and then moving forward with our practice. You need to do what makes the most sense for you and be honest with yourself about what makes sense in your body. Am I making any sense? I don't know, I hope I am. So as we move through practice, we're gonna get deep into some hip opening. You know, if there's things that I say that sound kind of weird, you know, we can have like maybe a little dialogue or check in about that now and forever, like always. I know it becomes a lot of a talking head when it becomes like the Zoom classes, and when we get a little bit more into each other in person, but like really feel free to pipe up or like we can chat afterwards about anything that's bizarre, because life is bizarre, man. So we're gonna get started with our face brushing. Take your index finger and thumb together, and then the squishy spot at the bottom of your thumb, bring that to the center of your forehead and brush outwards towards your temples. And then going from the sides of your nose out to your temples, along your cheekbones. And from their temples down to your chin, along your jawline. From the sides of your nose down to your chin on your laugh line. Then using your fingertips to massage just underneath and behind your ears, so feeling for the soft spot, loosening that, and then working upwards towards the bony spot and lifting up from there, keeping that lift as much as your body is willing to do so as you rest your hands down into your lap. Taking a few deep breaths, starting to settle into your body. Another deeper breath in through your nose, and big exhale through your mouth. Again, like that. Releasing three ohms or death growlers or screams, whatever resonates with you. Big breath in. Into child's pose as our first shape. So if you've been sitting up on anything, go ahead and move it. We'll come into our space, bringing your knees perhaps a little bit wider to allow your torso to rest down in between your thighs. And of course, hips up is fine, but if you can get your hips resting back, go ahead and give them a few wiggles to loosen that space. And wiggle your fingertips as far forward as you can get them, extending through your arms and your spine. Then let your head soften downwards towards the floor, resting your forehead. And if it's not resting, I want you to grab maybe your block or your block-like object and put it underneath your forehead so you're not having to hold on to your head. Because we do a lot of that. Isn't necessarily the best use of our energy or tension. Take two more deep, full breaths, in and out. Take your right hand and move it over a little bit, then take your left hand, put it on top of your right hand. Go ahead and rest your head down again, and then push outwards into both hands. Your torso started to shift a lot over to the right. See if you can relax your left hip back a little bit. I like to say these things like relaxing this space back or giving it permission to release, because sometimes we get very like held up and like, oh, why can't I stretch it? Why can't I release it? It's just tight. And that's okay. You're just giving your body this idea, hey, if you've got the room to change a little bit, why don't we give ourselves that gift? One more exhale. And then take your left hand out and bring your right hand on top of it. Rest your head down again. As you give your right hip permission to release back, you release any sort of judgment about whether or not it should get totally even or whether or not it should change a lot, and just say, oh, okay, I gave it the space that was available. One more breath in. Big breath out. Start to unwind yourself. And you're going to come up onto your hands and knees here. Now, we're going to spend a bit of time on the knees, doing a couple of things. If you want to give a mat, you want to fold it over in the middle, or just make sure that you have something squishy underneath your knees for some of these neck spaces. If you have a block, go grab it. If it's a beer growler or a protein jug, grab a pillow instead. You're gonna separate your feet just enough that you can set a block back there. And if it is a block or if it is a stack of books, just kind of coming onto maybe like the middle setting or the low setting. You can kind of test it out a couple times. You might get into this and then decide, it would be better higher or lower. And you can make that shift for yourself. We're gonna keep the right leg folded under and then take the left foot up. This is just going to give hopefully a little bit of space in our back as you start to take the fingertips back behind you. Now you've got a little elevation in the hips, so hopefully this isn't too tender on your knee. We're going to take the hips, lift them up, and then you have to turn your tailbone down towards your front knee and then set your hips back down. Now if you are already feeling a lot of this, ask yourself, is that enough of this? Then you stay exactly here. Maybe you bend your elbows back and get more of this, which is the quad stretch. Maybe, and you may decide this isn't the case for you, but maybe it would feel okay to come down on your right elbow. Maybe the left elbow. And then you might say, oh wow, this thing that I have underneath my hips, I should lower that down, or I should raise it up, or man, this really doesn't feel good. Why don't I go back to just having one hand or both hands on the ground? And then you do that. Two more breaths. And then coming up on both hands, we're gonna switch sides. You're gonna take the left leg in, you're gonna take the right foot up and forward. Now you might still have the tailbone kind of reaching down towards that left knee, or you might have to kind of wiggle around a little bit here. And then maybe it's just bent elbows. Maybe you need a few breaths with the bent elbows before you come down to one elbow, or you don't come down to an elbow. This is possibly the wildest thing that we'll do today. I know I'm kind of starting off a little bit intense. The most advanced version of this pose does not have the elbows down necessarily. The most advanced version of this pose is the one where you say, hey, I have a stretch. And I can breathe, and I don't feel like I'm just counting the very seconds and pleading with her to do this a little bit faster, yeah? This practice is about getting to know ourselves, about being present. One more exhale. And then coming up to the hands, if you went down to the elbows, and then you're gonna go ahead and tuck both feet underneath. You're gonna have to adjust on this block. You come back to having the body stacked. Just rest your palms facing up in your lap. Lean the backs of your ears, raise up off of your shoulders. And then we're going to start to move into some deeper hip stuff. So I'm going to take it, whatever it was that you had underneath your hips, move that off towards the front of your mat space. And we're going to come into swan pose. So you're going to sit over on your right thigh. Take your right shin up to where you're making it so that it lines up with the front of your space. So thinking of it being parallel to the front of your mat. And then the left leg, wiggle that back. I'm going to stay over on the right hip here. So it's different than pigeon pose. We're going to hold this as a yin shape. And then maybe you just take your hands forward in front of your shin and you work on breathing and finding some space here. Maybe you come down onto your elbows. And depending on how your hips and your body and your breath are feeling, you might kind of just draw these arms in and then rest your forehead down on your forearms. I know some of us might feel like, man, I can't move very far, I don't feel very flexible, and you get like a really, really big stretch without doing a lot. That's actually kind of cool because like you don't have to try as hard. Get a really deep stretch. People who have more space really kind of have to muscle themselves into having a lot of sensation there. So wherever you're at, wherever you're feeling the sensation, that's great. We're going to hang out here for another 5 breaths. Yourself up if you've drawn yourself downwards towards the floor. We're going to move from swan pose into lizard pose. Again, we're going to hold it for a little while and you're going to be on this back knee for a little bit. So please pad up your space, maybe put a folded up towel underneath your left knee. We're going to have the right foot up outside of the right hand. I want you to try to give a little bit more space between your front foot and your back knee. And then you're going to take your leg and you're going to tilt the weight over onto the pinky toe edge of the foot. And maybe from there, the hips can go further forward. Just resting on the pinky toe edge, letting the knee roll outwards. Knee and toe still facing the same general direction. If you really want to put your forearms down, if you've got enough space for it, maybe just your left forearm and not your right forearm, you can do that. You can stay up on your hands. I feel things in all of those places. There's a lot going on here. This is a deep one. Big breath in. Soften as you breathe out. Again, like that. Put the back of your hands up a little bit. You're going to wiggle your foot inwards, and then you're going to take your hands up onto your front thigh. So ideally, we still have a lot of space between the front foot and the back knee. You might even wiggle that foot a little bit further forward if it feels okay to you. If you feel like you still have control over yourself there, if you feel like you're gonna fall apart, back it up a little bit. Give yourself, put yourself back together. And then you're gonna take your elbows and you're either gonna bring the palms and the hands together or wrap the opposite arm on top. So if your right leg is forward, you're gonna wrap the left arm on top. Find eagle arms. And if you get here and you're like, I don't know where my hands go, just put them together. Okay? Now see if you can lift your heart up towards your arm bones. A little heart lift here. Push down into that front foot. It's going to help with your balance. Big breath in. Big breath out. Then you're going to unwind or separate the arms. Bring the palms together and your left elbow down to your right knee. Now, if this is a lot of twisting, then you're going to stay here instead where I have my hands on my leg rather than the elbow on the leg. Push into the hands, push into the front foot, soften your belly. Big breath in. Big breath out. And start to unwind yourself. You're going to take your right leg and bring it back so you've got two knees back together. And then leave your hips above your knees. Bring your arms forward. If your head doesn't touch the floor, I want you to grab a block and put it there. And then maybe you're on elbows instead of just on your knees. Here we go. Just take one more big breath in. Big breath out. Start to walk your hands back in. You're going to take your left leg. You're going to bring it forward. Sit on your left hip. Now all of the things on the other side. So you're going to bring the shin parallel to the front of your space. Wiggle the right leg back. I stay over on this hip. This leg just goes wherever it's able to go. And then I'm going to bring the hands forward. There we go. You bring the hands forward over your shin. Maybe down onto your elbows. Maybe not now, but maybe in like another couple of breaths. You're able to bring your forehead down onto your forearms. And if you never, it's like the rest of your life and your practice ever get your head down onto your forearms in swan pose, but you just like breathe and enjoy the space that you're in, then that is what this is about. That's what you're here for. Get about five more breaths. Yourself up. We're going to shift now into that lizard pose, and we've got that little tilt of the leg outwards. So you're going to have your foot forward. You just have that little shift onto the pinky toe edge of your foot, right? So it's not going to go directly forward. It's going to give you a little bit more space. We'll be there, nice and long as you can get. Let the foot tilt outwards. Maybe you're here. Maybe after a while, you have a forearm that comes down, maybe two. Checking in with the places where you've got tension, asking yourself if that's serving you at all, and if it's not, what can you do about it? Can you give it just the chance to release? More breath. And coming up onto your hands, you're going to wiggle that foot in a little bit more. Bring your hands up onto your front thigh. And now if you feel like you're going to fall apart, back it up a little bit. Bring this foot back in. If you can stay a little bit more open, pushing into that front foot, great. You're going to take your elbows together or bring the right elbow on top into eagle arms. keep the weight in the hips going forward, perhaps you're able to lift the heart upwards. Good.
One more deep breath in. Deep breath out. Unwind or separate the arms. Bring the palms together. It's the hands at the thigh or the elbow at the thigh as you drive your heart upwards into this twist. So lengthening your spine, ears out of your shoulders, softening the belly as you rotate. Keep pushing down into that front foot. One more round of breath. Starting to unwind yourself. I'm going to come out of that. Slide that left leg back, coming again into this puppy dog pose. So knees down again. Walk your hands out. Resting your head down.
Maybe it's on your forearms or a block, or maybe it is down on the floor. Let your tailbone roll up. Let your heart fall downward towards the floor. One more round of breath. Lifting your head up, go ahead and lower yourself down and forward. Make a pillow for your head with your hands. Rest a forehead or a cheek. Maybe let your pelvis roll a bit side to side. One more breath in. Soften with your exhale. Then bring your hands in. Start to push yourself back up onto your knees. So again, finding some cushion if that's going to serve you. We've got just a little bit more work on the knees here. Take your left foot and turn it out to the left. Take your right leg to the back of your mat and then walk your hands over towards the right side. You can turn your toes to face up and down. And up and down. Kind of strumming the leg around in the hip socket. And then letting the toes face forward. Maybe you roll the pinky toe edge of the foot downwards and let your heart come down. Now you might come down onto one forearm or both forearms or leave yourself back up on your hands. Letting your heart rest downwards as your tailbone starts to float upwards, just like when we were in puppy dog a little bit ago. One more exhale. And coming back up to your hands, you're gonna turn your toes up this time, bring your hands up to your hips. And the toes being up is probably going to let this hip roll down a little bit more, so your hips are a little bit more even. Sometimes the toes being down has this hip lifted. So it's our general intention and purpose in turning the toes up. You're going to take the left arm and reach it up. So I'm probably not mirroring you here. And reach upwards. If you can get a deeper side bend, and that feels okay to this like inner hamstring line, if you're like, my groin is not going to fall off, then that's great. You can go more to the side. And if it feels a little bit more tender, I want you to reach up. All right? So we're still reaching up even if you go up and over, but first reach up. One more exhale. Go ahead and bring yourself back up. And we're gonna switch the legs so you can just come right on down here. You can turn around to the other side of your mat if you want. I'm not going to because then I won't be facing you. It'll be very weird because you will have my bum and my shorts. You're going to take the leg and you're going to turn toes up and toes down. Kind of loosening up in that hip joint. And
And you'll have the toes down, trying to maybe reach that pinky toe edge outwards. And then it might be one or both forearms or no forearms. Coming back to your breath, as we always make the effort to do. Letting your heart melt down and your tailbone roll up. One more exhale. Locking your hands back in, lifting yourself up. We're going to turn the toes up, bringing the hands up to the hips. And then first reaching the right arm up, relaxing this hip down, maybe reaching up and over. And hopefully not coming to a place where like your body or central nervous system is like, ah, this is too much. Don't go there. Go to a place where you feel lifted, where you feel a stretch. Not like your body's coming apart or your brain's coming apart or your breath is coming apart. Big breath in. Stay there as you exhale. Go ahead and release from that. We're gonna come all the way down onto our bellies. So slide the leg back, lower yourself down. Again, resting your head on your arms. And taking your hands up and behind you, see if you can interlace your fingers and then pull your knuckles back to stretch your chest up and forward. Just two more breaths. Relax as you exhale, release your hands. Spread your fingers out, push yourself up. See if you can push from your heart into your hands. Strong across the upper back, and then come into downward facing dog. Wiggle your heels out, shift your hips side to side. Maybe give your head a little wave, yes and no. But keep pushing strong from your armpits right down to your hands. Wide spread fingers. One more breath. Feet come outside of the hands. We're going to come into a squat, and you might stay in this higher squat or lower your hips down. And if you do some foot wiggling until your heels are on the ground, that sometimes, you know, the feet need to get a little wider or the toes turn out a little bit. Lots of options. Wiggle yourself around. Heck, put a block underneath your hips if you want to have a little bit less tension in those hips. If you can bring the hands to your heart upwards towards your thumbs, and release your upper butt down and back. So even if your hips are up in line with your knees, you're releasing your upper butt down and back. Big breath in. Breathing out. And then you're going to take your hands down. If you're down with your hips, you're going to have to lift the heels a little bit to come into a forward fold. Wiggle your feet to a fist-width distance apart or hip-width distance apart. Bend your knees. Let your head hang down. Give the backs of your ears a chance to release themselves from your shoulders. Be sure that the weight is in your feet. Bend your knees a little bit as you roll yourself up, coming to standing. And then we're going to open the legs outwards. Turn the knees and the toes out. Come down into this Buddha squat. You're going to open the inner thighs. Push into the pinky toe edges of your feet. Take your arms out and open. See if you can release again your upper butt downwards. One more exhale. Straighten the legs. Lift your arms up, feeling your spine lift up. One more inhale, one more little reach. And then we're gonna go warrior two over towards the right side. So you're gonna have to adjust your feet, bend into your right leg, open the arms. So I am mirroring you for a bit here. Pull your right thigh bone back towards your left foot. And already feel that start to tilt you forward. Take the elbow down and your left arm up and over. Release the shoulder blade from your spine. You'll see my arm is just slightly forward. I'm still opening my ribs to the side. Still pulling this right thigh bone towards the back foot. Push into that back foot. Release the outside of the hip. Big breath out. Big breath out. And then start to release. Come back up. We're gonna turn the toes towards the front, reach the heart all the way up to your hands, long spine, and then keep turning over towards the left side, bending into that leg, coming into warrior two. Make sure your knee tracks in the same direction as your toes, and then pull the thigh bone back. You start to feel this tilt forward onto your elbow, reaching the right arm up and over. Release the shoulder blade from your spine. Push down into that back foot. Both sets of ribs are open to the side. Ears reach out and away from the shoulders. Where is your breath? Standing on both feet. That's a weird thing to say, but really, are you intentionally on both of the feet? Not just like kind of there, right? Big breath in. One more exhale. Start to lift it up. And turn both sets of the toes towards the front. Lift up a little bit longer through your spine. And exhale, we're in a forward fold. Now, you can do whatever. You can stay right here. If you're just working with your hamstring and your back flexibility, you stay right here. You soften into it. I don't want you to go forward to your hands. Huh? But maybe you can keep your hips where they are and wiggle your hands forward. And instead, be on fingertips if you're doing that. So I want you to touch. As so. So should be spine lengthening, not trying to dive into your arms or fall down onto your back. So the weight, you should really just fingertips, no weight in the arms. Maybe you can feel the pinky toe edges of the feet root down a little bit more. Little bend into the knees as you bring your hands back to your legs and stand yourself up. And then we're going to set up for triangle pose, and I want you to bring something on the inside of your right foot. Maybe that's a block. Maybe you go grab a stack of books or your kombucha growler. I don't know, whatever you're going to use that's going to go about on the inside of this foot. Now you don't have to use it for triangle pose. If your triangle pose is more up here and getting down to the floor there, it's fine, but you're gonna want that in a bit. In fact, I know I'm gonna want mine to be more on that middle setting. Yeah? So just whether or not you use it for triangle, you might have to adjust it lower in a moment. So all the toes face over towards the right, do a little shift into your hips, come down, triangle pose, reach the arm up. Relax that thigh bone back. Lift your heart up towards your hand. And the ears reach away from the tailbone. Can you feel the feet holding you up? Pushing the floor away, maybe feeling a little bit more expansive. Good. Big breath in. Big breath out. Then you're gonna look down, bend into your right leg. You're gonna take your left hand down towards the block. You might even move it lower. We're gonna pivot onto the back toes. You can put the back knee down. If it's too much for you to be up here, that's fine. But try to come to where your knee is above your ankle and not like kind of creeping back here. Lift those inner thighs. take the heart up towards the left arm. I love this kind of twist after triangle because it really helps to unwind any possible tension that triangle brings into the low back. Triangle can be a bit of a thing into the low back, so we're just giving a twist to release that. Is your right hip dipping down or are your hips balanced? Just notice that. One more exhale. Now, if you had your back knee up, I want you to drop it down. I'm gonna switch here so that you can see. You're gonna take your left knee and toe out, bring your hand further forward, and you're gonna rest down on your hip. You might have to even bring this foot in a little bit more. Okay. That's so a shift. So if you would be facing back there, but I'm not gonna put my bum towards you, I'll be here. See if you can lift your heart up a little bit longer. Now we're gonna push down to this arm. You can do this on your forearm if you don't wanna put a lot of pressure into your wrist. You could be up on your hand. You're gonna stand on this foot. You have to really press down into this foot to get the hips up. Maybe reach this arm up and over. You might have to wiggle this foot a little bit if you're like, oh man, my knee feels weird. Maybe your foot needs to go further away from you, and then see if you can breathe in again. And exhale. Take the hips down. I'm gonna roll over. Step up into a forward fold. And lift yourself up. Yes, okay. All the way through on the other side. I'm gonna do this. What am I doing? I don't know. Come into triangle on the other side. I'm gonna start facing this way. So all your toes are facing over towards your left now, should be. You're gonna shift your hips over. Take the right hand down, you've got the block on the inside, or the left hand down, you've got the block on the inside of the left foot, right? Or your beer growler, or whatever you're gonna use in that twisting lunge. Take the other arm up. Good. Notice what's going on in your back. It gets really easy to kind of curve this lower back. See, if I have the hips stacked, that's part of why I wanna release that top hip. It gives me lower back some space. Big breath in. Big breath out. And look down. You're gonna bend into your left leg, take the right hand down, pivot up onto the back toes, and lift this arm. Now you don't have to use the block or the beer growler here, but it sure makes it reaching down towards the floor a lot easier. You gotta lift those inner thighs, push down into the front foot, soften the belly. One more exhale. Lower your back knee. Turn the toes out. You'll probably have to wiggle it back a little bit. You're gonna move your hand out further and come down onto your hip. Lift your chest right here. Like I can feel all of those muscles that are right there on like the outer crest of the pelvis are like extend. And you can do this down on your forearm. You could be here, that's still getting into your hip, or up on your hand. I'm gonna press this foot down, lift those hips up. Good, oh man. Big breath in. Big breath out. Take the hips back down. I'm gonna turn yourself over. Step your feet up, forward fold again. When you get there, bend your knees as much as you need to get your belly and your thighs towards each other, or allow yourself to just maybe hold on to your elbows. If you need to not hold on to your elbows and hold on to your legs instead, please do that. If you can find the space to hold on to your elbows, just giving your upper back a chance to unhinge a little bit. If you're holding on to your legs, can you still think soft thoughts in your neck and your back? One more exhale. Release the arms, bend the knees, roll it up. Good. Okay, so we're gonna do a little balance shift here. We're gonna go from tree into half moon. It's gonna seem super weird, but you're gonna do tree standing on one leg, and then you're gonna shift the standing leg for half moon. Bear with me here. So you're gonna have probably a block out in front of, let's say, your left foot. And I've got it about a clown shoes distance in front of my foot. What is a clown shoe distance? Larger than what one of your own shoes would be. Just seems to work. So if it's in front of your left foot, you're gonna start off standing on your right foot and finding tree pose. You're gonna bring your left foot up on the inside of your right foot. It doesn't have to be the thigh, it can be your calf. But, oh man, I need to push the foot into the leg. Push the leg into the foot, so you're really squeezing into the center line. Lift your heart. Maybe reach your arms open. Notice I'm not taking the arms back behind me. I've got them just slightly in front of me, so I can use my back muscles to expand my arms. Lift your ears off of your shoulders. Now this space in my arms is going to be used as I go down into half moon. Still got all of this strength on this outer hip to hopefully support me. Take your left foot up, set it down, toes face towards your block. You're going to open out to the right, and then you're going to take the right leg up. So we're not trying to exactly stack the hips. You want to make sure that you can see your back toes. You feel the strong back, extend your arms. And then we're gonna forward fold. Just take both feet down. Don't put the weight into the block, but you can just let your fingertips there. Working with a fluid, relaxed spine through all of these roll-ups. So bend your knees, roll it up. Yeah. Cool, okay, other side. I'm gonna shift this way. There we go, okay. So you want the block, item, object, whatever is helpful to you in front of your right foot. We're gonna start standing on the left foot in tree pose, and I'm going for my thigh, do the calf. It does not have to be all the way up, but I do want you to push foot into leg and leg bone into foot, having your heart lifted, maybe reaching the arms out. Excellent. Release your collarbones right out to your fingertips. Reach the ears up off of your shoulders. You're going to take your right leg up, set the foot down, toes face towards your block, and then shifting into half moon. Shifted my gaze. It got really hard to hold myself up. Yeah. Reach out. Expand across the back, push into this lifted heel, big breath in, and then forward fold. Whew. Stand on your feet, not with your weight on the block in the hands. Let yourself relax. And again, fluid through the spine, roll it up. Now, if it's a beer growler or something like that you might squish, I would like you instead to grab maybe a pillow or just sit your hips straight down onto the ground or hold up in a squat, that's fine. We're gonna go down into a squat. I'm gonna take this down. I'll show you could go and take it onto its lowest setting. Maybe it's just looking at two books or something, giving yourself some space depending on the thickness of your book. Knees and toes face out. You're gonna sit down into a squat, or you know, if you feel good about it, be down, hips releasing back. Good. And you might just have your hips on the ground and your feet are out in front of you a little bit. One more exhale. And then you're going to take yourself all the way down. So you might move the block or shift until your bum is down. If the block was in the way, go ahead and set it off to your side. You've got knees out, feet towards each other. I'm going to wiggle side to side or manually adjust the flesh in the body and come forward, bound angle, Baddha Konasana or butterfly, any of the things that we call it, like it's all the same stuff. Having all of these like different lineages and interpretations and languages, and really it's just like feet together, knees open, relax your back, yeah? More breath. Start to peel yourself up off of your legs. We're going to shift so that the feet are wider and the knees face up. And then bring your arms down on the insides of your legs here. Just rest into it for a moment. Nothing crazy, just letting your heart soften forward. And then reaching your left arm down a little bit more, you're gonna push your left arm into your left leg, take your arm up and open, flip the palm back, take the back of the hand into the small of your back, and roll the shoulder open. Big breath in, breathing out, releasing your arm, you're going to slide that left hand down now, open your heart up towards, this hand goes down, this arm goes up, turn the palm back, bring it behind your back, I don't remember whether, I don't know what side we're on, do the other one, relax the top shoulder. Breathing in, breathing out, releasing this twist open. You're gonna take your hands down, try to reach them outside of your hand, of your feet. Maybe you've got the space for your feet to slide further forward. If you got, you know, here, and you're like, wow, this is an interesting place for me to work on breathing. That's what you do, is you work on breathing. If this is excruciating, go back to that bound angle or butterfly or Baddha Konasana. Similar kind of lower back releasing. This one's a little bit more into those hamstrings. Or a lot of it more into those hamstrings. If your head is hanging uncomfortably, please put something underneath it. Maybe a block, maybe it does reach the floor, maybe it's nowhere near the floor, and that's fine. One more round of breath. Start to pull yourself out from underneath your legs, coming up here. We're gonna shift into pigeon. We'll just go over towards the right side. So you're gonna take your right shin. You're gonna be on the shin. The knee is gonna point outwards. I've got my hip up this time. You can see I've got space underneath both my legs. Slide that left leg back. If this feels really uncomfortable, come onto your back. You need to maybe grab a block or something to put to the side of or underneath your right hip. then that's what you do. If you can come down into your forearms and that's comfy to you, go for it. Relax your right hip backwards. Check in with the places that you're holding tension. Ask yourself, do I need to be tense here? Do I need to be working to hold myself up there? Or can I soften that place? Is this serving me right now? Two more slow, deep breaths. And if you've been down on the forearms, come back up to your hands. If you've got something underneath your hip, move it so that you can draw that right leg back. And then send your left leg forward. The knee points out, not forward. So it's got that outward rotation. Wiggle the right leg back. Take, even just touching the outside of your hip. Like, it's not even really underneath my hip. It's not preventing me from sinking down more. It's just touching the point of contact. It can be very supportive there. And then maybe you come down to your forearms. Give yourself permission to relax anything that you might be holding here. I find I am often like getting into a place that feels fairly open and pigeon, and then I like hold myself there rather than allow further space to open up. And it's not like push yourself deeper if the space isn't available. It's ask yourself, is there more space here? Like, I don't know. Like, do I have anything else? Full round of breath. Starting to pick yourself up. Sliding the leg back. Moving whatever you've got around there. We're actually going to come down to a seat. Take your right leg up. Cross it over if that works for you. Lift your left toes. Lift your spine. Hug the thigh. Right arm back behind you, and then with every exhale, soften your belly. Get taller every time you breathe in. With every exhale, soften the belly into the twist. One more round of breath. Releasing your twist. Unwinding the leg, finding the other side. Lift those right toes. It helps to stimulate the lift of the whole rest of the body. Hugging the thigh and lifting up tall, softening your belly. Open from the heart out through the collarbone. Breathing in. Breathing out. knees in your twist. We're gonna unwind the legs, and I want you to come to sit up on something. And if you are like, I don't know, sitting crisscrossed or half lotus or whatever, if that doesn't feel good in your body, you can sit on your heels in hero's pose. You know, we kind of start it off like so. Go pop yourself up in a chair, prop yourself up against the wall. You can bring a pillow or a block underneath your hips in any of these places. Crisscross applesauce or half lotus. That's a weird way. That's the way that I like. I want you to come to a seat that works for your body right now. Not a seat that worked for your body, you know, other days or that you wish worked for your body. Come to a place where your body is at ease. Mostly. As much as we can be. We're going to try to let the body become, or the mind become at ease as well. I said that second sutra is that yoga is the ceasing of the stirring of the mind. Yoga is the state of this peace and ease that comes when we let go of all of the stirring, right? Like the worry and the what if, and even like, you know, hyper awareness. Like, we want to come into this place where we are maybe not so flustered by what's coming at us in the world. Let things fly up and say, ah, yes, this, not, oh my God, this, right? And like, there's so many ways in which we can kind of expound upon that. People say like, I don't know, I'm not good at meditating because I can't shut my brain off. And I don't want you to shut your brain off because your brain is also keeping you breathing and stimulating, you know, the rest of your body to like get your systems going. So don't do that. But can we still the brain? We're just gonna come into a seat that makes sense. Just explore some stillness. Maybe you focus on the breath. You tune into some of the longer, slower notes in the music. Feeling your breath or your senses ride that wave. When something pops up, a thought, a stirring, as it probably will, and experiencing that without judgment and without feeling like you're like bad at yoga because you can't just be perfectly still all the time. Like, we have this continuous practice that we're working towards, yeah. As you tune yourself back into your body, give yourself a moment to maybe relax your jaw or your eyebrows. And those are the most common places for tension and resistance to come in. And again, it's common, it happens. Give yourself the gift of releasing it. And then we're gonna start to come down onto our backs. And come off of whatever you've been sitting on. Lower yourself down, bring your knees into your chest, give yourself a little hug and a rock around. And then a happy baby, reaching your feet up, holding on to maybe the outside of the feet. I like holding on to the big toes. Rock around a little bit if that serves you. Last exhale, find something else to let go of. Releasing the knees in, let the arms go out, and then roll over towards the right side, finding a twist. Maybe you push down on the right arm to open the left side a little bit more. Soften your eyebrows. Starting to let go of the control of your breath. One more exhale. Moving your twist over towards the other side. Maybe wiggle using the left arm to open the right side a little bit more. Soften your belly. Breath. Coming back to the center, letting your feet down, letting your knees knock against each other, inquiring with yourself, hey self, is there anything else that I need at the end of my practice? Is there another pose or movement or adjustment that would serve me? Giving yourself whatever might be the answer to that question. Once you've answered, or once you've found that there's nothing else, we'll start to settle into shavasana. Perhaps this is corpse pose, legs extended, everything flopped open, a little snuggle of the shoulders under the back. Maybe you want to go back to that seated meditation and, you know, a similar pose or a different pose, or sit up against the wall. Any option that seems like a good place for you to rest. Thank you. coming back to your breath. Coming back to your body. And trying to keep any of the stillness, the softness, the not quite so stirredness that you may have been able to cultivate in this practice and in this shavasana, keeping that with you. The idea is that we keep coming back to this when, you know, we do it more and more often. Our bodies, our nervous system are more used to finding it. We know how to locate it just a little bit more easily when we need it. Starting to roll yourself over to one side, taking a moment to pause in gratitude for your practice. And then working your way up into your own version of a comfortable seat. Feeling our practice as we release an om together. Big breath in. Going down to the love inside of us, the light and the darkness within our hearts. Namaste, friends. Thank you all so much for being here. AWF folks, have a freaking awesome Monday. Everybody else also, thanks for being around. Good days. Let me know if you have thoughts about anything. Thank you, AWF.